category?
Do you know what an atheist is?
Someone who doesn't believe in God?
No, someone who believes the scientific impossibility that nothing created everything. Clouds, birds, trees, the seasons,
I don't believe that. Nothing
created
nothing.
So obviously there's a creative force.
To a degree.
Do you believe it's God?
No.
What do you think was in the beginning, Richard?
Germs, bacteria.
Germs and bacteria?
All that type of
That's all very complex. Bacteria is very complex. It's not a simple life form.
It's not.
We can't create a grain of sand from nothing. So there had to be an initial cause. The Bible says it was God in the beginning. God created the heavens and the earth. He made you separate from the creation in his image with a knowledge of right and wrong. Do you have a conscience?
Yep.
You know it's wrong to steal?
Yeah.
How do you know that? Yeah, no, it's not just that. How do you intuitively know it's wrong to steal? It's because you've been given a conscience.
Because it's yours, not mine. Why? It's not right for me to take what's yours.
Yeah, that's right. You know it's not right because you're a moral creation. You're not a dog or a horse or a cow or a cat. You know right from wrong. You know what the word conscience means? With knowledge.
Yep.
Con is with, science is knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Now, are you a good person?
Average person.
It's how to find out. Have you lied?
Yes.
Stolen?
Yes.
Used God's name in vain?
Yes.
Had sex out of marriage?
Yes.
Looked at pornography? Looked at woman lustfully?
Yes.
So, Richard, I'm not judging you, but this is why you don't want it to be the God of the Bible. You just told me you're a lying, thieving, fornicating, blasphemous, adulterer at heart.
Yeah.
You've got to face God on Judgment Day. If he judges you by the Ten Commandments we looked at four, you're going to be innocent or guilty.
Well, according to your guys' Bible, he forgives me.
That wasn't the question. If he judges you by the Ten Commandments, which are written on your heart, you're going to be innocent or guilty.
Guilty.
Heaven or hell?
Hell.
Now, does that concern you?
No.
It may not concern you, but it deeply concerns me. You know, I don't realize this, but I love you, I care about you. And I'm pleading with you because I don't want you to end up in hell. Because God is not like what we conceive him to be. He's the God of justice and righteousness and truth. And every time you sin, you store up his wrath. Just like if you violate the law and the police see you from a distance, every time you break the law, you're making it worse for yourself. Every time you sin, God sees your sin and you clock up his anger.
Yeah.
And it's going to be revealed on the day of judgment. God takes no pleasure in the death of the wicked. He's provided a way for you to have everlasting life. Do you know what it is? Well, God became a human being 2,000 years ago. Jesus of Nazareth, who suffered and died on the cross to take the punishment for the sin of the world. You and I violated God's law, the Ten Commandments are called the moral law. Jesus came and paid the fine. If you're in court, someone pays the fine, the judge can let you go. Did you know that?
Yeah.
He can say, Richard's guilty, but someone's paid his fine, he's out of here. He can show you mercy and still remain legal, do that which is right and just.
Right.
And God can legally dismiss your case, forgive all your sins,
right.
Let you live forever, commute your death sentence because of what Jesus did on the cross through his death
right.
and resurrection. The Bible says the gift of God is eternal life. The wages of sin is death. So if you're serving sin, you're going to reap death and hell. But if you come to Christ today and repent
wow.
of your sins and trust in him, God will grant you the gift of everlasting life. Richard, would you at least think about what we talked about?
Oh, I thought about it quite a bit.
Are you afraid of dying?
No.
Why not? Everybody is.
Exactly.
You've got a God-given will to live because God's placed eternity on your heart. There's something in you that cries, I don't want to die. I'm saying, Richard, listen to it. It's God-given.
Yeah, I do listen to it.
Yeah, well, listen to it today. When are you going to die? Could it be today?
Could be, yeah.
Could it be tonight in your sleep?
It could be, yeah.
Aneurysm. You know how many people die every 24 hours?
Yeah.
150,000.
I could die stepping off of this.
That's right. So please, get right with God today. You know what'll stop you getting right with God? Your love for sin. Because it gives pleasure.
Sin.
Yes, you do. You love fornication.
Who doesn't?
Well, there you are. That's right. So you've got a choice. You're like a rich man who dived into the ocean when his boat sunk. He had a money belt weighing 80 pounds. He would not let go of the gold money belt because he wanted to keep it. Took him to his death. Sin is like that. It gives pleasure. But if you hold on to it, you'll suffer the consequences. The wages of sin is death. You've earned it, but God will give you everlasting life. It's a free gift because he's rich in mercy. Okay? You have a Bible at home?
No.
You don't?
No.
Do you have a phone?
Oh, yeah, everybody.
You got 20,000 on your phone waiting to be downloaded. The world's most popular book tells you how you can find everlasting life.
Good.
Richard, I appreciate you listening to me. I really do. Okay? You've been open-hearted. You let me speak, not like the lady that was here before.
You let me speak a little bit.
What's that?
You let me speak a little bit.
Yeah, that was great. You want to say anything else?
Why do you feel so strongly about God?
Because he gave me life. And he's commanded us
what
to preach.
What happened to your parents?
What's that?
I thought it was your parents that gave you life.
My parents didn't give me life.
How did they not give you life? Didn't they fornicate?
No, they didn't fornicate. They were married. Okay?
But didn't they have sex then?
Okay.
So if they had sex.
Let me ask you the question.
They had sex and brought you into this world.
We know that. Birds and bees. Richard.
Yeah.
Where did your eyes come from?
My parents.
Your parents gave your eyes. I guarantee the last thing on your parents' mind when you were conceived was making your eyes.
You're right.